to your feet as they present our colors.
We're inside the battlefield at Ben Glover Stadium for the first of two MCPSS middle school championship football games. It's been said that it's tough to beat a team twice in a season, and for the Alba Sharks, they want to prove that theory true. Back in September, they lost a close one to the Lott Wildcats and would love to exact some revenge today. But for Lott, Alba is standing in the way of a perfect season that they don't want ruined. We're in store for a good one with the MCPSS Small Middle School Football Championship game. Good afternoon, I'm Al Whedon, joined by Corey LeBounty, and we're glad you're with us. Corey, we're going to be looking at some future Friday night stars in today's game.
Well, what you see, Al, is 8 weeks later, you're playing for a middle school championship, and it's going to culminate in a brand new stadium here at BC Rain High School, and excited for these young people to be able to showcase their talents after 2 months of hard work. All summer long, it's going to culminate today with a championship trophy going to one of these schools.
All right, let's take it down to the field and check out the coin toss going on between Alba and Lott. Lott is the home team and Alba is visiting, so they'll get the choice here. So our white hat today, or actually has on a black hat, Jonathan King, a guy we're familiar with from high school football, Corey.
Yeah, Jonathan King does a phenomenal job.
I say this before every game. All right, I've been knowing these guys for these for a long time. We don't care about who wins or who loses this ball game. All we have great sportsmanship. That's how we sleep well tonight, okay? We're going to call you black. You're my home team, okay? We're going to call you white. You're the business team. You speak? Come on, too. Come on to me. All right? Very good job. By rule now, business team is required to choose heads or tails. You're going to say a real lie that my umpire hear you over there, okay? Here you go, man. Just a regular old coin. Head. All right? And tail. All right, when I flip it in there, now you choose one, say it loud.
Tail.
All right, what'd he say? He said tail, it is tail. That means you win the talk. You wish to? Which is the first. All right, that means you want the ball, correct? Which end zone you want to play, young man? You want your back that way? All right, you will come on side by him. Y'all turn on side by him. Hey, listen, man. We're going to start on 35-yard line down that way. Y'all take care of us and have a good ball game. Good luck to y'all now.
Great job by Jonathan Keene explaining it. And something some of our listeners or viewers may be wondering, Corey, well, wait a minute. They're not going to kick the ball off. They won't be kicking the ball off. They'll take it at the 35-yard line. Here's a look at our officials, Jonathan King, T.J. Roberts, DeMarco Murray, Ron Morgan Sr., and Aaron Tillman. One of the different rules of middle school football, no kicking today and no punting as well.
Yeah, that's the biggest adjustment that you have to make from middle school to high school. And it's the same thing when you go to the parks and recreation.
Right.
You go ahead and we've always talked about the NFL protocol about safety, whether they're going to eliminate kickoffs or not. Well, we don't even have to worry about that in middle school football. They just go ahead and place the football at the 35-yard line, give them an opportunity on fourth down. If it's in close to the red zone area, they go ahead and go for it. But we'll get a chance right here quickly to see Lott Middle and see if they're able to stay undefeated at 7-0 or whether Alba can come out and give them their first loss in the championship game.
And it is a rematch of sorts. Lott defeated Alba 8-6 earlier this year. As a matter of fact, when they played last year, they defeated them 8-6 as well. Kobe Weaver's the quarterback. He's an athlete for them. He's going to keep it right there. Breaks it up to the 40. He's got plenty of room to the 40 of Alba, trying to get to the end zone. Kobe Weaver, first play from scrimmage. That's a 65-yard touchdown for Kobe Weaver and the Lott Wildcats.
That's the way you start off a championship game. You go ahead and you make a house call for the Lott team, and that's a great job of it's sideline way. He uses the sideline to his advantage, does not get pushed out of bounds, is able to go ahead and score that 6 points. And of course, we just mentioned no kicking. He'll have an opportunity to go ahead and go for two. We'll see a lot of teams go for two here.
Right. The Lott Wildcats, they are a feeder school to Citronelle, thus the color and thus the name of nickname of Wildcats. And the 2-point try is no good. So our early score after one play, Lott's on top, 6-0.
Hey Alexa, tell me about Mobile County Public Schools.
With 53,000 students in 90 schools, Mobile County Public Schools equips and empowers college and career-ready graduates. Several MCPSS schools are ranked among Alabama's top 10. Yearly, graduating students earned about $110 million in college scholarships and 10,000 career credentials. MCPSS is learning today, leading tomorrow. Does that answer your question?
A 65-yard run by Kobe Weaver gets us started off early here at the battlefield at Ben Glover Stadium. So it's going to be first and 10 for Alba as they come to the 35-yard line. Corey, we've got excitement already here.
First snap, first touchdown. We'll see if the Sharks have some bite in them on their first drive.
Quarterback keeper for Kai Von Sinkpachan. He's going to be tackled for a loss about 2 or 3 yards. Brings up second and long. And we have a flag on the play on the far side near the Alba sideline.
And you look at on the stop, Nolan Broadwater, eighth grader, makes that first contact at the line of scrimmage. And no gain, and we'll see exactly what the mark off is. Looks like the officials are going to mark it off against Alba.
Yeah. No line of scrimmage. You want the penalty? Men on the line of scrimmage, 5 yards.
So not enough men on the line, so almost like a legal formation, 5-yard penalty against Alba as they discuss the options. And it looks as if the head coach for Lott is going to decline the penalty. Jacob Warren's going to decline it, make it second down, Corey.
Second down and 10 yards to go, essentially no gain on that play. And we'll see here if the Sharks are able to get something going on their second opportunity. Darryl Harris, the back in the backfield for Alba.
Coming around out of that wing T formation and still on the move, J.J. Williams past the midfield stripe. He is the athlete, the go-to guy for Alba. Coach Jacob Whitehead told me he kind of does it all for the Sharks. That's a first down for Alba.
great job of getting around the edge. Javon Johnston, an eighth grader on the stop for Lott Middle, but that's a great job of displaying the speed of Mr. J.J. Williams in the open field. We'll probably be calling his name a lot this afternoon.
First and 10, ball's on the 45-yard line of Lott. Corey, I had to catch myself. I almost said Citronelle, since they are the Wildcats. Long Sinkpachine is going to keep it and falls forward near the 40-yard line. Brings up second and about five here for the Sharks.
Does a great job of just reading the offensive line, finding the hole, being very patient, and being able to fall forward. Positive yardage for Jacob Whitehead's offensive squad, and that's all you can ask for from a play-calling standpoint, is to gain positive yardage on first and second downs.
Alba plays a flex bone, triple option, sometimes the wing T as well. As I said, a lot of running you're going to see today from both of these teams. Alba's averaging 15.7 points per game. Williams goes into motion. They're going to hand off to one of the up guys with the carry right there. Darryl Harris picks up a couple. It's going to be third and short coming up here, maybe about 1 yard to go.
Fisher Jennings is going to get credit for that stop, but hitting the up man, and now you're looking at right around, they're going to officially call it the down marker. It says third down, so we're looking at third and two.
Third by two
for the Sharks.
Ball's on the 37-yard line. We only play eight-minute quarters here in middle school football, so it may go by pretty quick for you. Williams goes into motion, and we have flags on the play.
We'll start on the offense, third down.
So that third and two is going to turn into third and seven, Corey.
Makes it a little bit more difficult from a play calling standpoint, and you see a lot of running in middle school, and especially with the offense that the Sharks are running, it's not a passing type offense.
Right, right.
You see them ground and pound and misdirections, and you just have to make sure that you keep your eyes on where the ball is at all times if you're the Lott defenders, and that's what they're going to have to do here. But big difference between third and two and third and seven for Alba.
First time seeing trip receivers to the top here for the Sharks. Long Sinkpachine takes the handoff, looking to pass. His first pass attempt, pass is complete as he gets it out to Aiden Hoyt. And he's right at the line to gain, and I think we may have a first down here for the Sharks. The chain gain's on the move.
Great job of converting, and you look at the strike that is thrown to Aiden Hoyt, and he had to make sure that he secured it, was able to bring it in, and now you have a complete new fresh set of downs. The ball's going to sit right around the 32-yard line of Lott.
10-yard pickup on that pass reception to Hoyt. So first and 10 at the 32, as Corey just said. Von Sinkpachine going to keep it. He has one man to beat and does not beat him as he's brought down just outside of the 20. That was a touchdown-saving tackle right there by the Wildcats.
Kobe Weaver, we just finished calling his name,
scoring
a 65-yard touchdown, playing both ways for the Lott Wildcats. Does a tremendous job of an open field tackle, tackling him low, and that way you make sure that you're not going to give up that touchdown. But great quarterback keeper on that play, and the Sharks have a new fresh set of downs right at the 20-yard line, their first time in the red zone area.
12-yard pickup for Von Sinkpachine. Decides to keep it again. He's going to be tackled for a loss right there. See how many yards they'll say he went back, maybe one or two, so brings up second and long.
Nolan Broadwater, the eighth grader, coming up and making the stop there for the Lott Wildcats, and that's a big-time stop for them and not allowing any positive yardage. Matter of fact, tackle for loss.
Yep.
Going to see that they converted last time on third and long, were able to pass the ball. So here we'll see if Lott is able to stay disciplined and have great ball control and containment.
2 yard loss, second and 12 coming up. With the ball being inside of the 30, Alba wouldn't be able to punt this outside of the 30 right here. That's going to be a tackle for loss as they wrapped up J.J. Williams.
Nolan Broadwater once again being very active this afternoon for Lott Middle School, and now you're looking at close to a third down and 20 yards to go. And it was just moments ago you were looking at a third short, and now you're back to looking at a third and long.
About third and 16 from what I can calculate here, Corey. But, you know, we've seen, you know, one big running play. The first play from scrimmage for Lott was a touchdown. So depending on which running lane Alba chooses to go through, Williams goes into motion. They fake it. It's a pass. Von Sinkpachine overthrows his receiver, Darrell Harris. That's going to set up fourth down. So with middle school ball, there is no punting. So they will have to go for it from where they are. If they decide to punt, they would walk it off 30 yards. But it's fourth down right now.
That was a great wheel route coming out of the backfield by Darrell Harris. Just wasn't able to keep the football in play. And now when you're looking at fourth and exactly 18 yards to go, you know they're going to have to get the ball past the stick. So whatever throw they have, you have to make sure that it's beyond first down markage.
The line to gain is the 10-yard line to pick up a first down. Von Sinkpachine has time, goes across the middle, flashing right through that J.J. Williams. It's enough. That's a 20-yard completion, Corey. It's going to be first and goal from the 8-yard line.
What a throw. What a catch. He goes up like he has an elevator.
Wow.
And he goes and snags the football. J.J. Williams with an outstanding grab that keeps this drive alive. Fourth and close to 20 yards to go. Officially, it was 18.
Man.
But was able to pick up enough for the first down. They continue this drive in the red zone area. So credit Von Sinkpachine with an outstanding throw, but a better catch by J.J. Williams.
From what I can gauge, the ball is on the 9-yard line, so first and goal from the 9 for the Sharks. Give it to Williams. The Turf Monster almost got him. Look at him cut, Corey. That's going to be a touchdown, 9-yard score for J.J. Williams, and the Sharks are on the board.
It's the J.J. Williams show on that drive, folks. We saw him get the ball on reverse. We saw him making a phenomenal catch there to keep the drive alive, and then he punches it in from 9 yards out, and Alba takes their first bite of the scoreboard, and they're not, again, no kicking here in middle school, and I did not see the flag on the play.
There's a flag.
But there is one that was thrown that's going to negate that 9-yard touchdown.
Points come off the board here as Alba's pushed back to the 20-yard line. So maybe it was a hold on the play. That's almost about a 10-yard penalty there. So it's going to be first and goal from the 20 for the Sharks. That can be deflating right there.
Let's see if the Sharks decide to go ahead and go right back to number one. J.J. Williams is very effective on this drive, and he's shown. We did say we were going to call his name a lot this afternoon.
Right. Von Sinkpachine decides to keep it. That's a fumble. That's a fumble. Live ball. We have our first turnover of the ball game. And on first and goal from the 20, Lott creates our first turnover.
Nolan Broadwater with the hit from behind. Great job of stepping up into the pocket. Just didn't see the hit coming from behind. Stutter steps, and the defense continues to pursue. Great backside pursuit by this Lott Wildcat middle school team. And we're able to knock the ball loose, and now we're going in a different direction. Lott middle in business, going to have to go the length of the field to start the second quarter of action.
End of the first quarter here, and it is Lott on top, 6-0. So right now we're going to take it down to the field and check in with the principal at Alba, Mr. Jeremy McGuff. Mr. McGuff, congratulations on your Sharks making it to the championship game. How do the folks in the Bayou feel about this?
Oh, man, we're so excited for our players and our students and our school and our community. When we left the school earlier, the police escorted us out of town and business owners stepped out and supported our Sharks. It was a really cool experience for our kids and our community.
That's awesome right there. We know you guys are trying to exact some revenge. You lost a lot earlier this year. And let's talk about the history. This is Alba Middle School, but this is actually the former Alba High School. You guys are like in the same location, right?
Yes, sir, absolutely. I graduated from Alba in 1996, so it was a high school at that time, and now we're a middle school, and you know, that's where they created Alma Bryant, where they made Grand Bay Middle School and Alba a middle school, then combined to make Alma Bryant. So it's a great tradition, and when we play Grand Bay Middle School or Lott Middle School, it's always a great environment and good for our students.
Principal McGuff, we appreciate you taking our time to talk with us. Give us a little background. How long have you been the principal at Alba?
This is my second year as a principal. I was there 5 years as an assistant principal, and I went to elementary, middle school, and high school at Alba. So I'm back home, and I'm grateful to be their principal and to guide our community the best that we can.
Well, we do appreciate you taking out time to talk with us. We congratulate your Sharks for making it to the championship game, and congratulations. Hopefully you guys can secure the victory today.
Yes, sir. I appreciate you, and we're excited, so thank you.
All right. Principal McGuff right there at Alba Middle School. End of the first quarter into the second quarter, so we're going to flip the ends of the field here, Corey. It's going to be first and 10 for a lot from their own. What's that, the eight? I'm looking at the soccer lines. Is it the nine
right
or the eight,
Corey?
Right
nine. At the 9 yard line, they'll have an opportunity here to go 91 yards. Or 9 yards, rather.
Going to be a tackle for loss there. Alba trying to send a message as they push back, push back, push back. Brings up second down and long here for Lott.
And now you mentioned 8 minute quarters, and when you don't have the transitional periods of the kicking game,
correct,
and both teams spot the ball or run the ball a lot, it does make the quarters go by very fast.
So not second, I see the down marker says third down actually right here. So we got to be corrected. Actually, Alba has the ball. So maybe that fumble did not occur. So J.J. Williams with it as he's trying to get into the end zone. Did he roll over? No, he's going to be down at the 1 yard line.
Would have to go back and would have to ask our white hat tonight why that was not a fumble, because
right,
it clearly to us
we thought it was
here
a fumble.
Looked like a fumble from behind, but they saw something different on the field, apparently ruled them down, and the Sharks keep the ball and still have it goal to go.
Fourth to goal at the one. Von Singpachan, he didn't need to tush-push, Corey. He pushed his own self behind the center into the end zone.
Great job of the offensive line. Henry Gwynn, Jamarcus McCovery, Trevor Johnson, Jaden Marcet, and Colin Saucier doing a great job getting that push on fourth and goal, and the Sharks do take their first bite out of the scoreboard, erasing that turnover.
So maybe it was the interview with Principal McGuff that kind of changed the mind of Jonathan King. Because, Corey, I thought it was clearly a fumble from behind, knocked out by Broadwater, but apparently not between the quarter. They discussed it. The try for two here. This would give Alba the lead. Pressure on Von Singpachan. He throws it. Overthrows his receiver, Harris. We are not at six apiece as we start here in the second quarter of the small middle school championship.
I'm Keith Blackwood, your Mobile County District Attorney. I want to remind you about the truancy laws. 5 unexcused absences requires you to attend the early warning truancy program. Failure to attend the early warning truancy program can cause you to appear before a judge in circuit court. We need you to stay in school. This is a serious law, and it needs to be taken very seriously. I wish you and your family a safe, happy, and successful school year.
We are tied at 6-6 here in the second quarter off the 1 yard score by Von Singpachan. Here's a look at that fumble there, Corey. Maybe they thought the knee was down. I thought the ball was out, but we will play on 6-6. First down for Lott as they had a run there. Tackle for loss. Here's another look at it. The knee may have been down right there, possibly. Good job.
One of those bang-bang plays.
Good job on the replay, yeah.
And great job of being able to clarify that. And the officials, when they see it in real time, saw the knee being down, and that is a bang-bang play. They don't have the benefit of what we just were able to see four times. And in real time, it looked like his knee down, and Alba was able to capitalize, and Lott's now going to have a chance to march the field and put six on the board.
Second and 11 coming up for the Wildcats. Weaver on the keeper. No gain on the play. Both of these teams, as we said, they played each other early in the year. We'll try to get their schedules up here to let you know the path that they took to get to this particular ball game. Here's a look right here at Lott's schedule as it comes up. Undefeated on the season here. They had one forfeit. Williamson forfeited a victory to them. But Corey, look at them. They're averaging 23.7 points per game on offense. They put up 46 on North Mobile County. We only play 8-minute quarters. That takes a lot to do that. So that's how Lott got here, undefeated 7-0. Third and long. Weaver with the carry here on the near side, outside of the numbers. Tackled by J.J. Williams right at the 39-yard line. So it's going to be fourth down. Let's see if Coach Warren is going to go for it or if they'll walk it off. If it's a punt, they'll walk it off 30 yards.
Well, what you love to see is a situation to where you see your best athletes on the field,
right,
and offensively and defensively. For Alba, it's definitely J.J. Williams making that stop. And we mentioned there are no special teams here, Al. So because there's no kicking in the special teams game,
right,
you go ahead and they place the ball right at the 35-yard line.
And here's the road on how Alba got here, a 4-3 record. As you see, they lost a lot, 8-6. And they've been kind of up and down, win, loss, win, loss, win, loss here. Lost to Scarborough 20-16, but they won the critical one over Denton. That was the playoff game, 8-6, to make it into the championship game here. So it's going to be 1st and 10 for the Sharks. They're going to place this ball, let's see, at what, 32, 33? They haven't spotted it just yet, but that was a great defensive stop by Alba right there.
Corey, I mean, what you have to do is you look at Weaver trying to hit the corner and was not able to go ahead and stretch out and get that first. J.J. Williams with a huge stop, and now Alba with the football once again, trying to have another successful drive.
1st and 10 from their own 31. Williams goes into motion. They fake the toss. They get it, hand it off just in time to running back Ashton Porter, but he is tackled immediately. Maybe he picked up one, possibly two.
Another great job of giving it to the up back. And if you're defensively, you have to make sure you read your keys and stay home and make sure that you're not looking at the quarterback, because there's a lot of motion, a lot of movement that you can get fooled with. And Lott trying to do a great job staying home. And now you're looking at a 1-yard gain on that 2nd and 9 for Alba.
Porter with that carry. You may notice the locks. They call him AKA Joe Dirt. Coach Whitehead said he's one of the, he wears that mullet with pride. Von Sinkbachan pops it out. That's a fumble. The pigskin comes out. Let's see if Alba recovered it. And I believe they do. Jonathan King is signaling 3rd down.
Outstanding textbook tackle by Braylon Williams, the 8th grader for Lott Middle. You look at the way he was able to make sure he had his head up and was able to cause that fumble, and that one being recovered, and it's going to be a 1-yard loss. So you are able to recover the football, but you have a 1-yard loss because of it.
Back to the original line of scrimmage. So 3rd and 10 from the 31 for the Sharks. Jacob Whitehead in his 2nd year as head coach, and Lott's head coach Jacob Warren was the former offensive coordinator for Alba. They used to work together. They said they had really good buzz. They could talk all the time. Kind of reminds me of Lev Holly and Jeff Kelly at Sarah Land when Lev Holly was at Blunt, Corey.
Yeah, it does. And you're going to have a first call timeout here by Alba, making sure that they have things under control here with 2:43 remaining in the 2nd quarter. But so far, you see the fireworks on the first play of the game.
I mean, Kobe Weaver took it to the house, 65 yards, and got us started. play one.
And then Alba's able to negate that turnover that we thought was a turnover. The referees on the field did a great job and saw something else. And Alba's able to punch it in and 6-6. And you saw their schedules earlier. 8-6 was the final score when the two teams played earlier this year. And that was the difference in the two-point conversion with the 8-6 final. So now here, everything, every point is going to be critical from thus forward, moving forward. But Alba's offense, now with 2:43 and two timeouts remaining, you've seen Von Sinkpachan being able to throw the football effectively to J.J. Williams.
And hitting his main guy, J.J. Williams. Coach Whitehead told me he's the go-to guy. I guess when you get to high school sometimes, they kind of label you as an athlete. He's that kind of guy. Said he can run a 4.740, Corey. They've clocked him in middle school already. So the kid has speed. He's got talent.
Absolutely he does. And when you have that type of speed, you just try to find a way to utilize it for the Sharks. And we'll see here if they're able to find him in the open field on some type of pass or coming back to the football.
Offensive coordinator Joseph Horn has dialed up trips here to the near side. Empty back set. They're setting up a screen. They get it to J.J. Williams, the playmaker. He's going to be tackled. Not enough for the first down. So it's going to be fourth down coming up for the Sharks.
Great open field tackle right there. And you do look at, because there are no special teams, you can either roll the dice and go for it or actually have the officials to mark it all for you and it be the Wildcats football. So decision time here coming for Alba.
Looks like to beat about fourth and six, maybe fourth and seven. Coach Whitehead talking to the official. Guess he's deciding it. You can see Jonathan King near the hash waiting for the call. And Alba is going to elect to give it over on downs. So they'll walk it off 30 yards, and it'll be Lott's football after that.
Well, what you do like to see is the fact that you do see some high school kickers not be able to kick it 30 yards. So the benefit of the doubt, you don't have to worry about a shank punt or it being blocked or anything like that. You automatically mark off that 30. And now we'll see here if Lott is able to capitalize right before the half. And I do love the support of breast cancer awareness. You still see the pink in the stands and the pink that the players are wearing, whether it's their undershirts or their spats, in support of breast cancer awareness.
You're right about that, Corey. And Lott is definitely doing it. Spats, they got a lot of the cheerleaders on the sidelines and the folks in the stands. First and 10 from the 30. Weaver's just going to keep it, rolls it right up the middle, picks up about 6 yards on the carry for Lott.
Positive yardage, but the clock continues to run, and Lott does have three timeouts at their disposal, ball placed right at their own 41-yard line, and looks like they're not in any type of hurry here. You did see the speed earlier of Kobe Weaver, so we'll see what else this Lott team has up their sleeves to get six on the board.
Hand off to one of the running backs right there for the Lott Wildcats. Braylon Williams, his first time touching the ball offensively, picks up about 3 or 4. Going to be third and short coming up. 67 seconds remaining here in the first half. I think that's a smart move by Jacob Warren to call a timeout.
Henry Gwynn on the stop, the defensive end for Alba, and you do have the timeout, 107 remaining.
All right, we're going to take it down and talk to someone from Lott Middle School. Mr. Jason Golden is on the line with us. We get him and talk about. Mr. Golden, can you hear me?
Yes, sir.
All right, congratulations on your Wildcats making it to this championship game. 7-0, talk about the excitement up there at Lott Middle School.
Yes, we've had a great year athletically as well as academically. Our young men have been fighting hard, 7-0, as you said. We're looking to end the year today 8-0 and become district champs, just like our volleyball team did 2 weeks ago.
Yeah, that's right. We know athletics are important, just as important are academics as well. And we love the fine job that you guys are doing up there at Lott. Talk about your experience as principal there at Lott Middle School, and tell us all about it. A day in the life of the principal at Lott.
Well, every day is a new adventure, but I'm definitely at the place where the good Lord would like for me to be, and I'm happy to be there in my ninth year. We've done a lot academically over the last 9 years, improving in our ACAP state test scores in both math and reading, and just bringing programs that will help our students be successful at the next level when they get to high school and beyond, making those college and career ready programs. We also are one of six schools in the district, as well as piloting the LOTC program, a leadership program for our young men and young women, so they can be successful and give back to our community.
Principal Golden, we appreciate it. Right now, your Wildcats on fire. A nice pass from Braylon Williams to Kobe Weaver. You guys got a first down. Let me get you off the mic. They're trying to score so you can enjoy this.
Well, thank you. Thank y'all so much for what you do for Mobile County Public Schools and our young ladies and young men.
You are more than welcome. That was a big play right there, Corey, and a timeout called. I think that's a good another good timeout call by Lott.
Well, when you look at the ability of Weaver, we mentioned the best players on the field making the best plays. J.J. Williams for Alba. You look at the replay, a strike. Great job of going to high point the football by Kobe Weaver. We've already seen him with the 65-yard touchdown run, and now we're looking at him with another 35 or 40-yard reception.
Man,
that
was a big bomb.
Lott Middle, and it is one of those situations now with 45.4 seconds remaining, and you still now having one timeout, you're sitting and knocking on the red zone area. Why not go right back to your playmaker, especially if Braylon Williams is able to put the ball on the money the way he just was able to do.
That was a sweet spiral pass right there from Williams to Weaver, and it looks as if Weaver's going to line up again at receiver, and they're going to let Braylon Williams take another run at it. He is the backup quarterback. Keeps it right up the middle, quarterback keeper, as he falls at the 20-yard line, about 2 or 3 yards shy. Let's see if Coach Warren's going to burn that last timeout, and Jacob Warren does call the last timeout. 33 seconds remaining here in the half. Second and short will be coming up for the Wildcats.
Trayshawn McCall with the stop coming from his defensive back position. 33.7 seconds remaining. Lott with no timeouts to go here in the first half of this small division championship middle school style here at Mobile County Public School System. And Alba just trying to make sure that Lott stays off of the board. And we go into halftime tied at 6 apiece.
As we said, Lott comes into the ball game undefeated. Alba comes in at 4-3. Coming up at halftime, we're going to be featuring the cheerleaders for both of these fine middle schools. Plus, we'll give you some information about the Leadership Officer Training Corps program. So stick around for halftime. And, Corey, I do have to tell you, halftime is not as long as high school. So no bands. And so don't veg out and say, I'm going to eat me a sandwich. Don't do that, Corey. We're going to be back in a hot second.
No doubt about that, Al. Quick return to action. 10-minute halftimes here in middle school football.
Williams still in at quarterback, just going to keep it. They only need 2 yards. But he's outside the numbers, 10 yards, one got a beat, and he is brought down. But a flag on the play right near the 25-yard line, probably in the vicinity of holding. Let's see what the call is going to be from Jonathan King.
And if it is against the Wildcats, bring that one back, which would be huge.
Yep.
Because there was just outflanked on the right side of the field.
And on the offense.
That might have been an important reason why they were outflanked when you do have a holding, but that negates a huge run by Braylon Williams
holding
along that right
on
side.
Offense. We play second down.
And it does.
Yep, push the Wildcats back to the 30, a spot foul.
But Al, it did a great job of trying to find the open green grass.
Sure did. Sure did.
This artificial turf to the right side. Again, just being outflanked to that right side. And now he'll just have to get his composure, Braylon Williams, and try to find Weaver in the end zone.
Second down, Williams passes it again, looking for Weaver. J.J. Williams swats it away. That stops the clock with 7.8 seconds remaining here in the first half. Corey, as you talked about the turf and the green grass, for the Lott Wildcats, it's their first time ever playing on field turf.
Yeah, I mean, it makes a difference to where when you're on this bouncy, rubbery surface that is this artificial turf at Ben Glover Stadium. But I know that here with this last play, third and 12 yards to go for Lott Middle, just go ahead and get the ball into the end zone. And you just throw it as far as you can and hope that Weaver or the tip drill, somebody's Johnny on the spot, but at least try to get it into the end zone here.
Williams just going to keep it on the ground. And it looks like we're going to go into halftime tied 6-6. Quite interesting. When they played earlier this year, the score was 8-6 Lott. As we go into halftime, the score is 6-6, Corey. A very interesting first half. Started off by the first play of the ball game, which was a 65-yard touchdown by Kobe Weaver.
Yeah, when you're playing for the middle school championship, it's always great to be able to get the nerves and the jitters out, especially on the first play of the game. And that's exactly what we saw. Six on the board quickly. And
yeah,
you go back and what we looked to thought was a fumble,
right,
which would have been a turnover on downs, change of possession there. Did not happen. Alba kept it within goal line situation, was able to punch it in. Six apiece. Great middle school championship game. Second half action coming their way.
All right, don't move. We have the cheerleaders coming up. So keep it right here. It is halftime.
What's the matter, baby? You're not feeling good?
School-aged children are at a higher risk of getting and spreading germs and viruses. To help protect the spread, students are encouraged to stay home when sick. Parents, it's important for your child to remain at home at least 24 hours after they no longer have a fever of 100 degrees or higher without the use of medications. Please help us maintain a healthy learning environment.
We're going to take it down to the field of Ben Glover Stadium and check out the Lott Wildcat cheerleaders.
Wildcats, we came to Ben Glover, fight, win. Wildcats, we came to Ben Glover, fight, win. Wildcats, we came to Ben Glover, fight, win.
Good job, guys.
the Alba Sharks cheerleaders. Right now, I want to let you know Mobile County Public Schools is the first school district in Alabama to offer the Leadership Officer Training Core Program, or LOTC. The program is offered to middle schoolers in grades 6 through 8. The LOTC focuses on character, discipline, and leadership. Here is more on the LOTC program.
Hello, my name is Andy Bennett. I am the owner and president of Interactive Learning and the co-creator of the Chisel 365 Leadership Curriculum and Technology. For the last 20 years, I've been working in the schools and with our nation's JROTC programs. I was asked to give a real quick interview and answer a few questions about our Chisel 365 curriculum. So, first question was, why did we see a need for this program? Kind of back to the name here, character, health and fitness, interactive, service, and leadership. That's what we were trying to deliver. We found that high school was too late. It was too late to wait for high school to get these students in this program that could change the course of their life, give them identity, give them a hope for a bright future. So we needed to create that earlier on and catch those kids, get them with healthy habits and communicating better, just becoming better citizens and better leaders.
Detachment, attention. The Cadet Creed.
The Cadet Creed. I am Leadership and Character Development Corps Cadet.
The way it works, the way it's supposed to work, is a program we invite the little kids to come in and be a part of the program. Because we figure like this, you know, a lot of middle school kids come in and they either join band or they go to PE because they want to be athletic. But you still have those kids who don't want to be in band and they know they're not going to be athletes. So we recruit those kids so we can put them in a leadership program because we know leadership is something that they can use for the rest of their lives. And those kids that we bring in who are non-athletes are the ones who stay in the program all the way through. You know, even though in the seventh grade they can become athletes, a lot of them come back once their season is over. So the great thing is that we capture them, we teach them how to team build, we have fun activities for them, and they want to stay.
Well, the first thing it does, it offers them a place in the school. It is a program built for any and every student. Every student can find their place in LOTC. Every student will evolve into something greater if they do this program. It brings good out of them, brings the confidence out of them, skills out of them. It's a program that's built for all students.
When I was in the program, I didn't really think much of it. I thought it was just another fun program to be in, but the longer I stood in it, I really realized how much it highlighted leadership skills, and that really made me want to stay.
So in life, it made me reach out to more people. It made me connect with others that I wouldn't normally talk to. It made me build relationships with instructors, and they have helped me throughout school.
I could not see any reason that you would not have an LOTC in every middle school. If you have football, if you have band, if you have the arts, why would you not offer this leadership program in alignment with those other groups? When you search for leadership programs, we've looked high and low. There's not a lot out there for something that I have seen with the return on investment. I don't know what it even costs to start up an LOTC program because we've always had it, but I know that we wouldn't do without it. And just recently we're looking at budget cuts and no one's looking to cut out LOTC, but it's the foundation of our culture. And we have a culture of high expectations where young men are developed into real world leaders. And that's what LOTC has provided for us.
It really helps kiddos with just leadership opportunities. We are also an international baccalaureate school, and so we use that as what we call a design course. And so kiddos learn a lot of different qualities and within the program, you know, in terms of leadership and how they can become better people, better citizens. And so all our sixth grade students take LOTC. seventh grade is an elective and eighth grade is an elective as well.
This program absolutely works. It absolutely works. We started off, like I said, we started off with one. When I got here, they put three more in once I got here. And now we're up to 15. And more schools all over Texas. We got 20 programs in Fort Worth. We got 29 in Dallas. We got 15 up in Houston. We got another five on the outskirts of San Antonio. So we got about 85 programs in Texas alone. Absolutely it works. As the rate is growing, we'll be bigger than JRTC in the next 5 years.
We welcome you back to the battlefield at Bean Glover Stadium. We're all tied up here in our first middle school football championship. This is the small school division. Notched up 6-6. Alba's going to get the ball first at the 35-yard line. They deferred to the second half, so we will see what the Sharks will come out with here in the second half, Corey.
Well, you look at their scoring drive that they did have, and it was a great drive that they were able to put together, and J.J. Williams was instrumental in leading that drive, whether it was on reverses or whether it was him receiving the football. So we'll see if he plays a role here to start the third quarter, as the Sharks have it, as you mentioned.
Fake the handoff. Fung Sing Pachan is just going to be wrapped up right there about 2 yards behind the line of scrimmage for a loss.
Javon Johnston, the eighth grader, does a great job from his defensive line position, making sure that there was no additional yardage gained at all. Matter of fact, a 2 yard loss on the play, so a great job of him getting into the backfield for the Wildcats. And if you're the Wildcats, you just want to continue to make them go the wrong direction here at Ben Glover Stadium and get into the backfield and create long down and distance situations.
Two receivers to the top. Fong Sing Pachan, pressure on him. I can see that face mask from here atop the press box at Ben Glover Stadium. That's going to go against Lott, Corps.
You look at the instant replay. Ryan Broadwater timed the gap perfectly and was able to shoot it. And if he would have got a little lower on the quarterback, there would have not been a penalty call, but because he got high, was able to grab the birdcage, Von Sinkpachan does a great job of trying to step up into the pocket, but got his face mask and is going to give him free yardage.
3-15.
Face mask on the defense, going to be first down.
Moves the ball up to the 48-yard line. Costly penalty right there for Lott. First and 10 coming up here for the Sharks. Lining up in that same formation, two receivers to the top. And handed off to Williams. And boy, look at the Wildcats swarm all over J.J. Williams. That's about a 5-yard loss, Corey.
That's what you have to do. Anthony Snow, the eighth grader, in the backfield. You don't want him to be able to get upfield at all. And the penetration and at the trenches, getting it done at the line of scrimmage. And it's going to create a second down and close to 15 yards to go.
Ball's placed at the 44-yard line. Second down and long coming up here for the Alba Sharks, 4-3 on the season. Trying to win the first championship for Jacob Whitehead in his second year here at Alba as head coach.
And just have to make sure that you hold on to your blocks, especially second and long. Allow your quarterback, give him time to find the wide receiver to get to his route.
They put Williams in the slot at the top of the screen. Empty set. Williams goes into motion. They fake the jet sweep. Von Sinkpachan tripped up right there near the line of scrimmage. Picks up about one or two as he is tackled at the shoelaces.
Fisher Jennings, number 45, the eighth grader, does a great job of staying home. And 1 yard gained on that. And It'll be a long 3rd and 13, but we've seen the Sharks convert earlier. And
right.
At 5:20 left here in the third quarter, the clock goes by so quickly because we're on 8-minute quarters here.
That's right.
In middle school football. No punting or special teams play, so we'll see here on third down. This is a critical down for them to go ahead and get close to the sticks, the first down marker.
Empty set, Von Singpachan back there by himself. And I believe we have a flag on the play thrown here on the near side, near the Lott sideline.
Prior to the snap, encroachment on the defense.
So that's a free five for the Sharks as the Wildcats jump off sides.
And you'll definitely take those yards and try to capitalize. Big difference between 3rd and 14 and 3rd and 9.
Right.
And the ball will be placed right at midfield for the Sharks. And what you have to do here is just give your quarterback enough time, or go ahead and get a hat on a hat and allow your quarterback to be able to hit one of the gaps that are open and created by the offensive lineman.
Third down here for Alba. Big play, ball at the midfield stripe. Once again, Von Singpachan trying to go up the middle, and once again, the Wildcats all around him.
Great job by Ryan Broadwater getting into the backfield and essentially forcing Alba to punt. And they'll walk off those 30 yards unless they decide to go ahead and go for it. And they're making that decision now on what they want to do with it. They are going to punt it.
They are going to punt it. So Lott's going to take over. Nice defensive stand right there by the Wildcats. Got to send a big thank you and a tip of the hat to Coach Lawrence Yielding and the Rain crew for allowing us to come down playing host today for us for both of these championship games. So, speaking of sending big thanks, got to shout out the Lott Volleyball Small Division Champions. Principal Golden just talked about that course, so congratulations to those young ladies, the Small Division Champs for Lott Middle School in volleyball.
That's huge when you do look at establishing a championship culture that goes to up to the middle school. It champions breed champions.
Yep. And there's our large division champions, the Causey Tigers. So congratulations to those girls, volleyball champions in the large division. Oh, Braylon Williams on the move, crosses the midfield stripe up to the 30, the 20, cuts back. Look at the cut, Corey. He's going to take it to the house, but I think the house may be closed. There is a flag sitting at the 29-yard line of Lott.
Well, the lights are on, but nobody's home in regards to having to bring that one back. A flag right at the 30-yard line is going to bring a tremendous touchdown run all the way back and cost the Wildcats 6 on the board. And you hate to see that, because now what you've seen erased is an Alba touchdown.
Correct.
Taken off of the board, and now you've seen a Lott Middle score taken off of the board as well due to penalties. And unfortunate, but I love the fact that when you do look at the replay, if we're able to bring that up, he put on the brakes. Great job of putting on the brakes at the point of attack, and the quarterback slash defensive back, Kaivon Singpachan, was the only one that could stop him.
Only one. It was a hold against Lott. It's going to push them back.
But you do see the explosiveness here that can be presented by Braylon Williams. And, you know, sooner or later, he'll go ahead and take some deep breaths and try to reciprocate and duplicate what he just was able to accomplish.
Spot foul on the play, so they're going to push it back to the 19-yard line. Weaver on the move again. Corey's trying to take another one. Von Singpachan was the last guy to beat. Kobe Weaver hits pay dirt. His second touchdown of the game for the Lott Wildcats. Let me make sure. No flags on the play.
Well, what you saw is a touchdown run to the left, taken off of the board. Guess what? We can do it to the right as well. Great, outstanding run by Kobe Weaver, showing the burst and the explosiveness. Great job of the offensive line, and not an angle that Kyvon Singpachan was able to capitalize on.
Right.
And you know he's got to be gassed because now he has to turn around and play quarterback for Alba as well. You saw him try to take the angle on the touchdown that was called back, tried to take the angle on this one, wasn't able to do so. And
he played strong safety. It was quarterback on quarterback. That was an 81-yard run by Kobe Weaver. And Corey, he's going to stay in the game and play some defense when Alba gets the ball as well. Play is stopped. Jonathan King coming to the sideline to talk to one of the Wildcats, one of the coaches. Talking to Coach Warren. So we may have had a penalty assessed. Let's see if Jonathan King is going to go to the other side and talk to Coach Whitehead.
Sideline warning. Making contact there. That's
there
tough.
There he is. That is unfortunate.
You only have four officials, and you know, you get excited there as he's running down that sideline and you see him make contact. It's going to result in a touchdown, but
no personal foul assessed against Lott. And here's the try. Weaver with the keeper, and he's going to be stopped. So our score is 12-6. Lott in control. We'll take a break and be back with more action.
Did you know that missing 2 days of school per month
has a negative effect on student achievement?
And that chronic absenteeism is negatively impacting
one out of every 10 Alabama students.
Studies show students who are chronically absent are more likely to drop out of school. For every 1 day your child is absent from school, it takes 3 days for them to catch up.
So if I am not sick, make sure I'm at school, because missing school means missing out.
We are back. Let's take a look at that last play. I believe we have found out where the coach ran into the official, and there it is. That's actually head coach Jacob Warren, Corey.
Out of a little excitement trying to chase his player down the sidelines, and it was a wonderful run by Braylon Williams and Kobe Weaver both. One was called back, one was not, but
so
on the one that was for six,
I guess he was outside the coach's box, huh?
Yeah, he definitely was outside the coach's box. And what you want to do is just try to stay out of the white paint area.
Right.
Behind the white paint, and was not able to do so. And
so that means Alba's going to take that penalty here on the kickoff, which we don't have. So they'll get the ball at the 50-yard line. Great field position for the Sharks here. They fake it. Fake it again. Von Singpachan remains in the ball game, plays defense and offense. You've noticed a lot of these names were calling on both sides of the ball.
Camden Chestang, the eighth grader, with the stop for the Wildcats. And I know this much, Kai is definitely going to sleep well tonight.
Yes, yes. Second down and about 4 or 6 yard pickup right there by Von Singpachan.
Great game so far here. 2:10 remaining in the third quarter of action. 8 minute quarters for middle school football.
Line it up in that flex range offense. That flex bone. Von Singpachan with the carry. He's close to the first down stick, Corey. He might be short by about 1 yard.
Anthony Snow on the stop for Lott Middle. The eighth grader playing in his last middle school football game, making sure that Alba does not pick up that first down. It's third and one.
Third and one coming up. Speaking of coming up after this ball game near 6 o'clock, we're going to give you the large division game. It will be Causey versus Pillins. So you get a double hitter today with a score.
Absolutely. Small and large division middle school championship games here on the MCPSS television network.
Wildcats fans getting excited. Third and short coming up for Alba. Von Singpachan runs into his running back. but has the composure to fall forward.
Ball taken
comes
away.
Out. I think
away.
It was a can opener drill, Corey. That's a fumble. They stole it away from Bunsinkpachan.
Just depends on if they decide to mark his momentum. They're going to say it is a turnover. Great job of Javoris Coleman.
There's the replay there.
Ripping it away, the seventh grader. He just rips the football away from Kai. And because of it, a huge turnover there. And Lott is going to be able to take advantage. Great job of stripping the football. He was still moving forward.
He was.
Great job of the officials not blowing it dead, allowing him to continue to try to gain yardage. But even better job of Coleman stripping that football away.
The effort from Bunsinkpachan backfires. Lott with the turnover. Now we officially have our first turnover of the ball game. Kobe Weaver from the 38. As he's weaving his way, keeping those legs churning, he ran a long way to get 2 yards, Corey.
What I love to see, though, he keeps the feet churning. Mm-hmm. Never stops moving the feet and continues to try to ground and pound and protects the football as well. Second and eight, you mentioned a lot of running just to get those 2 yards.
He ran a long way to get 2 yards.
The good thing for him, he was able to get positive yardage out of it, and we've seen the explosiveness of both Braylon Williams and Kobe Weaver for this Wildcat squad here, getting ready to start the fourth quarter of action.
Wildcats don't have to snap it. They do. Hand it off to Braylon Williams. He reverses field as he is tackled at the 40-yard line. That brings the third quarter to an end. Three quarters in the book. The deciding quarter awaits. The fourth quarter's on the way. Lots on top, 12-6.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Ayla, hi.
Oh, hi, Sierra. How are you?
Good. How are things?
Things couldn't be better.
What do you mean?
Well, I just started this new job as a school teacher with the Mobile County Public Schools, and it has been a life changer. Great benefits, the hours are great, and great students. Just the overall, it's a great opportunity.
Oh, wow, that sounds great.
Yeah.
I'm gonna look into that.
You should.
For more information, visit mcpss.com/job opportunities.
At Mobile County Public Schools, we are learning today, leading tomorrow, and leading here in the small division championship game are the Lott Wildcats, 12-6. They defeated Alba 8-6 earlier this year. Corey, this is the rematch, if you want to call it. Alba trying to get some revenge, and no sweeter way than to get it in the championship game, but they're down 6 points right now.
Well, when you look at being undefeated, 7-0, Lott Middle, trying to make that 8-0, a perfect 2 months of football is what they're trying to receive, and you have a motto and a slogan in Centronelle, Jason Rowell. He is a Centronelle graduate, high school football coach. We saw them here at Ben Glover Stadium a couple weeks ago.
Sure did.
And what he wants to do is lock the gates. And what better way to get momentum going in building a Centronelle program than to win a middle school championship?
That would be huge, right?
And it's going to boil down here to one quarter left to decide the small middle school champion here in the Mobile County Public School System.
Third and eight coming up here for the Wildcats. Weaver hands off to Braylon Williams. Looked like they were trying some little trickeration, almost like a flea flicker. But he is going to be tackled for a 1 yard loss, so that's going to bring up fourth down. That play did not go anywhere.
Henry Quinn from his defensive end position stays at home and is able to drag him down. There was going to be some trickeration.
Yep.
There was going to be a pass, but it wasn't clean enough. Great job of getting into the backfield, disrupting the timing of the trick play, and there's going to be a punt, which is essentially no actual punter or in middle school football. They just mark it off 30 yards from the spot of the line of scrimmage, and we'll see if Alba is able to go ahead and get on the board here as we begin the fourth quarter of play.
That was good defense right there by Alba to shut it down, so they're going to take over the ball here. Spotted at the 30-yard line. Down 6 points. 7 minutes, 13 seconds to play. Corey, you're right. Yeah, man, it flies by here in middle school ball.
It really does, and this is for it all, Al.
Yep.
You have a chance here, if you're the Sharks, to capitalize and get something going. And You want to see J.J. Williams to see if he's able to get a ball.
Fake the handoff to Harris. Von Singpachan is going to keep it. He's bottled up. Picks up about two or three, so we'll credit him with, say, 2 yards here. So second and eight coming up for the Sharks.
Great team tackles for Lott. Javon Johnston on the stop. And you're looking now at close to a 3 yard gain. Second and seven officially is what it will be for the Sharks.
3 yard pickup for Von Singpachan. As I said earlier, don't forget we have more action headed your way after this one. The large division championship, Causey Tigers versus the Pillins Eagles will be coming up. Coming up right now, second and seven for the Sharks. They fake it to Williams. Von Singpachan once again, and boy, they're all over him, pulling his jersey, bringing him down.
Fisher Jennings, the eighth grader, gets into the backfield and disrupts all the timing because this offense is predicated on timing and being able to pull and get out there in front to create room for the quarterback or the running back. Now a huge third down and 6 yards to go for the Sharks, with 5:52 remaining here in the fourth quarter of this small division middle school championship.
I've heard you say Fisher Jennings' name a few times this afternoon, Corey. He's making his presence known today. Darrell Harris in the backfield. Blitz, blitz. Von Singpachan is sacked for a loss. The defense of Jacob Warren and his Wildcats turn it on.
Nolan Broadwater from the left defensive end position does a great job of timing that snap, getting into the backfield, coming away with a huge sack for this Lott Wildcat team. And we do have an injury timeout.
That's
on the play.
Von Singpachan slow to get up as the Wildcats take a knee. They show respect there. Coach Jacob Whitehead tending to his quarterback. I mean, it was perfect timing, as you called it, Corey. Head coach Jacob Warren is the defensive coordinator, and he dialed up just the right scheme right there for that play.
Absolutely great job of not jumping off sides and watching the ball and timing and getting a great jump and a great start. And now it's going to create a punting situation for this Alba offense, and they'll turn around on defense and try to create some type of turnover because there's 5:04 remaining in this fourth quarter of action. And Lott, they have a couple of playmakers that we've seen tonight, Kobe Weaver along with Braylon Williams, that they'll have at their disposal here trying to add to this lead.
Up 6 points with just over 5 minutes to play, as you said. This is kind of a situation where if you can just control the ground and pick up a couple first downs, you can kind of milk this one away, Corey. Hand off to Braylon Williams, keeping it on the ground. Got to protect that pigskin. Don't get it punched out. Williams turns the corner. Got to wrap that ball up because you can see the Alba Sharks trying to knock it out.
Yeah, you definitely want to protect the football high and tight as the running back. You have to make sure that you do secure that pigskin. But great job on the right side of this offensive line and being able to bounce to the outside and picking up 8 yards, second and two now for the Wildcats. And the ball is located right around the 47-yard line of the Sharks.
That's where I see it at. Nice 8-yard run by Williams. In the backfield, Williams, Weaver, and Javaris Coleman. Weaver's going to keep it. They push him out wide. He turns the corner just outside the 50. Plants right there at the 40 and just stands up and says, hey, you guys just tackle me right here. That should keep the clock running. His forward progress stopped in the field of play, so he wasn't tackled out of bounds. A late flag comes in from Jonathan King. Don't know if there were any extracurriculars going on there.
Just have to keep your cool as you see teammates talking to teammates there for the Wildcats, trying to make sure that you don't have anything that will cost your team great yardage. But
right.
Great heads up of Kobe Weaver staying in bounds, keeping the clock running.
Going against Alba.
Unsportsmanlike called against the Sharks.
Unsportsmanlike conduct. That's 15 yards. Does not help the situation at all for the Sharks. They're down 6 points. And just like that, Corey, we're down to under 4 minutes remaining here in this small division middle school championship ballgame.
And that'll give them a fresh set of downs, first and 10 now. And you'll be able to keep this with either Weaver or Williams
right,
securing the football, depending on who decides to play quarterback. We've seen Weaver go out to wide receiver, and he's going to stay at quarterback here on this possession and has the opportunity to keep it or give it to his buddy, Mr. Williams.
Weaver keeps it. Flag comes in as he goes out of bounds. That flag near the 20-yard line might be a hold against the Wildcats. Let's
yeah, that's exactly what you'll have. You'll
wait
have
the
a
call here.
Bring that one back.
Yep.
Right on the numbers where it's in the vicinity of holding.
Got to thank the fans for making the trip down from Citronelle and the trip up from the Bayou. Good little turnout here, Corey, today at Ben Glover Stadium for this championship game.
On the offense, first down.
And some great weather we have as well.
Oh, you have to love this fall weather that we're being blessed with here. And even if it would have been raining, because we do have the artificial turf.
Correct.
Here at Ben Glover Stadium. That's what's great about these new facilities built by the MCPSS. You don't have to worry about the inclement weather affecting the field conditions for sure. Ball's going to be right at the 31-yard line now.
First and about 16 coming up here for the Wildcats. 3:21 to play. Hand off to Williams, right up the gut. Braylon Williams goes, and that's going to be a 31-yard touchdown as Lott extends their lead.
No flags on the play. You give it to your playmakers, and the Sharks defense have been on the field a little too long.
Yep.
And you get a chance to see the explosive speed of this eighth grader, Braylon Williams, 31 yards to the house, trying to secure this small middle school championship. Four Lott, 3:09 remaining now.
Lott on for the try. Fans chanting it up. Weaver with the keeper, and the two is good. So Lott in control on top, 20-6. We'll take a break and come back with the last 3 minutes and 9 seconds.
Do you feel alone, overwhelmed, or helpless?
There's hope. There's hope. Call or text 988.
You don't have to face your crisis alone. If you need a safe space to talk with a trusted adult for support, reach out to your school counselor.
Do you need help to make it through everyday struggles?
Do you need someone to talk to?
Call or text 988. Your social emotional wellness is worth it.
Remember, there's hope. There's help.
The purpose of the Mobile County Public School System is to equip and empower college and career-ready graduates at Mobile County Public Schools. We're learning today and leading tomorrow. Corey, Lott was leading, and now they're leading more after that 31-yard touchdown by Braylon Williams. They really wanted to secure the victory, if you want to call it that way.
You look at Braylon Williams, he does come limping off of the field. Not quite sure if it's just a cramp, because after him catching that 31-yarder, it does look like a cramp that they're massaging there on the sidelines as he went down on the two-point conversion. But Alba has to have some type of bite left in them here if they want to go ahead and make a comeback.
Von Singh Pachan throws it wide open. Was the Shark player incomplete? Pass intended for one of the Sharks. They got to go into my roster, Corey. I think it may have been Kevin Lindsay. If not, Henry Wynn. Coming over from defense.
Wynn.
Yep.
That's right. And you'll pull out all the stops. Second and 10. The good thing is it does stop the clock with 3:04 remaining in the fourth quarter in this first championship game of two. And we'll see here if they're able to get J.J. Williams the football on this drive.
He's been the money guy for them today. All in the face of Von Sinkpachan, and I believe that ball came out. It was almost out, but his knee went down before the defender could actually bring it in.
And once again, it's Nolan Broadwater making a living there from that left defensive end position, being able to be in the backfield before Kai Von Singpachan can even turn around. Yep. That's the second straight possession that you've seen number 12 in black and gold make a huge difference for this Lott Middle School defense.
I believe timeout has been called by Alba, and boy, the Lott Wildcat fans are up. They can sense it. They can taste it, Corey, because it is third and about a country mile coming up here for the Sharks.
Third and 21, as a matter of fact. And you know you have an opportunity because there's no special teams. You can choose to go for it on fourth down, but not the likelihood there. You just want to try to find some type of penalty here or find number one.
Von Singpachan airs it out, trying to get to J.J. Williams. Pass incomplete. Fourth down. And they will be going for it here.
Yeah, when you look at the score, 20-6, trailing with 1:58. You do have three timeouts remaining. So you can call that timeout to gather yourself and have your best play call season for head coach Jacob Whitehead. The decision time, but one, you look at an opportunity for perfection here in a perfect 8-0 season that Lott can finish with. They're 1:58 away from that.
Jacob Warren and his Lott Wildcats, the defense only allowing 4 points per game this season. They pitched 4 shutouts this year and only given up 6 points today in this championship game. So the defense has truly stepped up for the Wildcats today. And no surprise, because Jacob Warren, as I said in the first half, used to work with Jacob Whitehead down at Alba as the defensive coordinator. He did tell me, Corey, you know, he'll be glad to win, but it kind of breaks his heart because the kids across the field, you know, he was coaching them when they were in fifth and sixth grade. So he said, they're kind of like my kids too, man.
Absolutely. When you are very familiar with personnel and faces and names, there's always faces and names under the helmet. And that's the great part when you do have those teachers that are not only excelling in their sport, but in the classroom as well here in the Mobile County Public School System.
All right, here's the ball game here for the Sharks. They need to get on the board and get a stop and get back on the board. Empty set, Von Singpachan looking to the sideline for the call. They get it to J.J. Williams, the playmaker. He's not wrapped up. He's still on his feet, but tackled just shy of the 40-yard line. That was fourth down. It'll be ball over on downs to Lott, and the Wildcats can kind of taste it.
Alba only having 2 timeouts remaining. So mathematically here, when you look at them being able to try to stop the clock, because there is no punting situation here, it's going to boil down to 4 down territory. You're going to have a stop on first and second down, or Lott will try to run out the clock.
Sharks down 2 scores with 1:46 remaining. And you talked about it earlier in the fourth quarter, Corey, about locking the gates up at Citronelle.
Oh, yeah.
And Lott trying to lock it down right now.
One first down, Al, and this game is over.
Braylon Williams with the carry. And that's the first down, Corey, as you just called it. Fresh set of downs here for the Wildcats, and the clock continues to run as we approach 90 seconds, and all the Wildcat faithful on their feet, excited as they are about to capture this middle school championship.
And a great, like you mentioned, a great crowd, great turnout by both of these middle schools and their fan bases to cheer them on, and that's the excitement that you love to see.
Right. First and 10 for the Wildcats. Fumble. Alba on top of it. Kobe Weaver was trying to pitch it to Williams. Williams kept running, and we have a turnover with 57.7 seconds remaining here in the ballgame.
Well, you have a choice whether you want to hand it off or whether you want to keep it, and a little miscommunication between Weaver and Williams. Williams thought that he was going out to block, didn't even look to get the football, and a great opportunity for the Sharks. If it was a one-score game, then you know that that would have been a vital turnover. Henry, but because it's a two-score game.
Correct.
Now, mathematically, there are no special teams onside kicks, so you have to score here as quickly as possible if you're the Sharks.
Henry Wynn recovered that fumble for the Sharks. They still live. Von Sinkpachan has a guy wide open downfield. That's Henry Wynn. He's trying to get to the end zone as he is tackled and brought down right at the 15-yard line.
Look at the hustle, though, because if you don't have that hustle on the play by Ryan Broadwater, that is definitely 6 points on the board. Now, as soon as the ball is spotted for play, it's going to go ahead. The clock's going to continue to run.
And there it is.
And that's going to be utilized. You're going to may have to take a timeout or spike the ball here on first down. And I would go ahead and burn the timeout to go ahead and save time. And that's exactly what head coach Jacob Whitehead is going to do. He didn't want to burn it.
It lost about 10 seconds there, Corey, because the ball was spotted to play.
Well, you know, you go time and situation. Definitely in high school and in middle school, you just have had a big play to where you're gassed and your offensive line isn't running to the line of scrimmage as quickly as you would like them to. The referees are in place ready to put the ball in play, but that's a great timeout being called by Alba, and even more explosive play. But again, the hustle to make that tackle and to go ahead and save 6 points on the board. 33.7 seconds remaining. Alba with one timeout remaining. And officially, it looks like the ball is going to be spotted right at the 15-yard line.
Jacob Whitehead and the Sharks breaking out of this huddle near their 25-yard line, down two scores. Critical error right there by the Wildcats on the handoff that led to this situation. First and 10, empty set for the Sharks.
Find number one if you're Alba.
Von Sinkpachan looking that way. Pass is thrown, and it is a touchdown for the Alba Sharks as they get on the board right there. Kelvin Lindsay, our first time calling his name today, put six on the board from Von Sinkpachan.
Great job of the quarterback, Von Sinkpachan, of keeping his eyes up despite being almost tackled, and an even better job of Kelvin Lindsay getting wide open. And now I don't see a flag on the play.
It is, Corey. It is all for naught. It's against Alba.
Wow. And that's huge, because not only does it take off time, you lost close to 13 seconds on that play. You also take 6 points.
Takes the points off of the board.
But you still have an opportunity here.
First and 15 from the 20-yard line.
Kelvin Lindsay or J.J. Williams are your options.
We aren't done yet. Pressure coming in from Sinkpachan. Ball is out. And that should seal the deal for the Lott Wildcats as the clock continues to run. A couple seconds trickle off. Down to 3 seconds, and Von Sinkpachan can't believe it. He's beside himself. Also, Ashton Porter right there in disbelief as the Lott Wildcats are going to secure their middle school championship in the small division. And they're lining up for the handshake, Corey. What a ball game shown by both of these teams today.
Absolutely. You do see both teams play an outstanding game, bringing it all for the championship, but Lott remains perfect. Not only did they lock the gates for 8 weeks, it's great for that community moving forward, for them to go ahead and look at going into high school, knowing that they were middle school champions. It's a great foundation for the Centennial Wildcats high school program especially, but an undefeated season is hard to do at any level.
You're right about that.
8-0 is exactly what they were. And They'll forever remember this moment to where they were middle school champions here in Mobile County.
Congratulations to Jacob Warren and the Lott Wildcats that they pick up the win today. Remember this name, Corey, Kobe Weaver. Citronell, watch out. He's going to be headed your way because, as you said, Citronell, they're locking the gates, man.
Absolutely. Braylon Williams, too.
Also,
with that
yeah.
long touchdown run down the middle of the field. You saw him play both ways
sure did.
Today for Lott Middle School. Caught cramps at the end of the game, but you never saw Lott give up. You saw the relentlessness of them, and they were able to come away with a championship.
All right, that wraps up our first ball game today. Congratulations to the Lott Wildcats as they pick up the win and become the small division middle school champ. So congratulations to Lott. Don't move, our second ball game's headed your way. We're going to have Causey and Pillins coming up next on the MCPSS TV network.